What's up guys, Enschig here. In this video, I'll talk about the interesting life of paper wasps and I'll show you how well is my colony doing. Before the video starts, I want to thank you for all the support in 2020, even though I wasn't uploading as much as I should. We almost reached 200 subscribers and we are on a good way to grow much more than I did with my previous English videos. Speaking of them, many of you might not know, but I have many more English videos about ants. You can find them all in the playlist linked in the description. Some of them were re-uploaded on this channel. Now with that said, let's start with the video. I got some of the information from polistes.sk and other webs. You can find links in the description. And how is the colony? Well, it's surprisingly good. Let's summarize what has happened since the last video. On March 20th, I caught 5 females that were after hibernation and were waiting for suitable conditions. I moved them to the insectarium and placed them on the windowsill of the south window. With constant conditions around 22 degrees Celsius and the longest possible direct light. 7 days later, on March 28th, they began building the nest, scraping off pieces of cardboard and mixing them with water. They chose the place to establish the nest on the side, not on the ceiling of the cork sheets, but they know best what to do. They continued to build the nest for another 20 days. They built about 2 to 3 chambers a day and the dominant female laid 1 egg in each. Sometime during this period, 2 of the queens died. Cause is unknown. One I found buried in paper and the second was laying on the sand. On April 16th, the first cocoon appeared and on the 17th, it was completed. I could even watch the larva as it was making the cocoon so that it can turn into the pupa. For the next 2 weeks, the remaining 3 queens continued to build the nest, gradually adding new chambers, and more cocoons were appearing. On April 25th, the first larger cocoon appeared, protruding from the nest about 1 centimeter. I didn't pay much attention to it. On April 30th, the first worker emerged from its chamber. And how to recognize her? At first glance, she has a smaller abdomen. Otherwise, she looks just like the queen. Each wasp, not males, has a different shape of a mark on its forehead. That way, they can recognize themselves. You can see this in the thumbnail of the last wasp video. 7 days later, on May 7th, the first male appeared. I couldn't film any worker without hardened exoskeleton, because they harden inside the chamber and then they bite through the cocoon themselves. This is in contrast to ants, where a worker or a queen pulls out a new worker out of the cocoon and then the worker hardens outside the cocoon. And since then, on May 9th, there are about 15 pieces of wasps in total and every other day it changes. I think I can declare myself as a successful wasp keeper. I change the paper every 2 weeks. I give them water and sugar whenever it runs out and I try to feed them every day. I will divide all topics into several parts. Each time I release a video about wasps, there will be an update on the colony and some information about their lives. Today we will look at the life cycle of the colony, and next time the construction of their nest. Wasps live in one-year communities of workers, females and males. Depending on the species, the colony differs in size. Native species, a few dozen, Polistes dominula, more than 100 individuals. Colony development is related to temperature and food availability. Only young queens hibernate over winter to next season. I'll use these terms. Female, queen, a fertile female wasp. Male, a fertile male wasp. Worker, an infertile female wasp. The cycle has several phases. It begins in the spring, when new queens look for a nest site for their colony, especially nectar from flowers. Females of the European paper wasp can combine, and there can be many queens in one nest. Right in the first days of the nest, the most dominant female strengthens her position with aggression towards other females. Other females begin to do the work of workers. They take care of the nest and feed the alpha female. With the first workers, the other females are ejected from the nest or killed. The workers take care of the whole course of the colony. Proteins for larvae, sugars for adults, and scraps of wood for the nest building. With increasing temperature, the first males appear in May to June. In the next phase, the production of workers is ending, and starting from June, females in particular appear. Males and new females do nothing. Females are just gathering supplies for winter hibernation, and they are all waiting and searching for a special place where they can mate with other wasps. In the last phase, with the loss of food and heat, the original queen and workers die. The newly mated females gather in certain places, where they can hibernate until the next spring. That would be the year-round life cycle of the wasp community. I hope you enjoyed this information-rich video, and I would appreciate it if you could share this video and show it to others who might like it. What do you think about wasp keeping? Do you think you could also keep wasps? Do you have the courage to do it? Share your thoughts in the comments. I will read them all. If you don't, then follow me on Instagram. I'm active there a lot, and I can help you with wasps and ant keeping. Thank you for being interested in such a video. Bye!